I have thought it necessary to send to you Epaphroditus, my brother and fellow worker and fellow soldier, and your messenger and minister, and Apphia, our sister, and Archippus, our fellow soldier, and the church in your house. Share in suffering as a good soldier of Christ Jesus.
Beyond the boundaries of your city's lights, stand the heroes waiting for your cries. So many times you did not bring this on yourself. When that moment finally comes, I'll be there to help. On the day when you need your brothers and sisters to cheer, I'll be right here. Sinners and soldiers, holding the life of the ones that we died from the dark of despair. Standing on guard for the ones that we shelter. We'll always be ready, because we will always be there.
And I heard the voice of the Lord saying, whom shall I send, and who will go for us? Then I said, here I am, send me. No soldier gets entangled in civilian pursuits, since his aim is to please the one who enlisted him. We know that the whole creation has been groaning together in the pains of childbirth until now. And went and woke him, saying, save us, Lord, we are perishing. Truly, truly, I say to you, whoever receives the one I send, receives me. And whoever receives me, receives the one who sent me. As the Father has sent me, even so, I am sending you. And he said to them, the harvest is plentiful, but the laborers are few. Therefore pray earnestly to the Lord of the harvest to send out laborers into his harvest. Will you not say, there are yet 4 months, then comes the harvest? Look, I tell you, lift up your eyes and see that the fields are white for harvest. Already the one who reaps is receiving wages and gathering fruit for eternal life, that sower and reaper may rejoice together. For here the saying holds true, one sows and another reaps. I sent you to reap that for which you did not labor. Others have labored, and you have entered into their labor. For since in the wisdom of God, the world did not know God through wisdom, it pleased God through the folly of what we preach to save those who believe. And he said to them, go into all the world and proclaim the gospel to the whole creation. Go, therefore, and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father, and the Son, and behold, I am with you always, to the end of the age.
Dying in the fullness of the home. It is trying to kill a man, which is trying to know.
And Jesus said to them, follow me, and I will make you become fishers of men. Whoever is not with me is against me, and whoever does not gather with me scatters. What do you think? A man had two sons, and he went to the first and said, son, go and work in the vineyard today. And he answered, I will not. But afterward, he changed his mind and went. And he went to the other son and said the same. And he answered, I go, sir, but did not go. Which of the two did the will of his father? They said, the first. Jesus said to them, truly I say to you, the tax collectors and the prostitutes go into the kingdom of God before you. The harvest is plentiful, but the laborers are not.
Jesus Christ, let me be set in the others free.
strong in the Lord and in the strength of his might. Put on the whole armor of God, that you may be able to stand against the schemes of the devil. For we do not wrestle against flesh and blood, but against the rulers, against the authorities, against the cosmic powers over this present darkness, against the spiritual forces of evil in the heavenly places. Therefore take up the whole armor of God, that you may be able to withstand in the evil day, and having done all, to stand firm. Stand therefore, having fastened on the belt of truth, and having put on the breastplate of righteousness, and as shoes for your feet, having put on the readiness given by the gospel of peace. In all circumstances, take up the shield of faith, with which you can extinguish all the flaming darts of the evil one. And take the helmet of salvation and the sword of the Spirit, which is the word of God, praying at all times in the Spirit, with all prayer and supplication. To that end, keep alert with all perseverance, making supplication for all the saints, and also for me, that words may be given to me in opening my mouth boldly to proclaim the mystery of the gospel, for which I am an ambassador in chains, that I may declare it boldly as I ought to speak. You became imitators of us and of the Lord, for you received the word in much affliction with the joy of the Holy Spirit, so that you became an example to all the believers in Macedonia and in Achaia. For not only has the word of the Lord sounded forth from you in Macedonia and Achaia, but your faith in God has gone forth everywhere, so that we need not say anything. And someone said to him,
Lord, will those who are saved be few?
And he said to them, You call me teacher and Lord, and you are right, for so I am. Why do you call me Lord, Lord, and not do what I tell you, not do what I tell you, not do what I tell you? Jesus said to them, Follow me, and I will make you become fishers of men. For I am not ashamed of the gospel, for it is the power of God for salvation to everyone who believes. Go and stand in the temple and speak to the people all the words of this life, and that repentance and forgiveness of sins should be proclaimed in his name to all nations, beginning from Jerusalem. And he commanded us to preach to the people and to testify that he is the one appointed by God to be judge of the living and the dead. Remember your leaders, those who spoke to you the word of God. Consider the outcome of their way of life and imitate their faith. To me, though I am the very least of all the saints, this grace was given to preach to the Gentiles the unsearchable riches of Christ. Be imitators of me, as I am of Christ. So they went out and proclaimed that people should repent. You go and do likewise. In those days, John the Baptist came preaching in the wilderness of Judea. Repent, for the kingdom of heaven is at hand. You go and do likewise. From that time, Jesus began to preach, saying, Repent, for the kingdom of heaven is at hand. You go and do likewise. Now after John was arrested, Jesus came into Galilee, proclaiming the gospel of God and saying, The time is fulfilled. And the kingdom of God is at hand. Repent and believe in the gospel. You go and do likewise. Then he began to denounce the cities where most of his mighty works had been done, because they did not repent, because they did not repent. You go and do likewise.
For my way is not just. Is it not your ways that are not just? Therefore I will judge you, O house of Israel. Everyone according to his ways, declares the Lord God. Repent. And turn from all your transgressions, lest iniquity be your ruin. Cast away from you all the transgressions that you have committed, and make yourselves a new heart and a new spirit. Why will you die, O house of Israel? For I have no pleasure in the death of anyone, declares the Lord God. So turn and live.
You go and do likewise.
Good job!
You brood of vipers, I want you to flee from the wrath to come. Bear fruit in keeping with repentance, and do not presume to say to yourselves, We have Abraham as our father, for I tell you, God is able from these stones to raise up children for Abraham. Even now the axe is laid to the root of the trees. Every tree, therefore, that does not bear good fruit is cut down and thrown into the fire.
Repent! Repent!
And as Jesus reclined at table in the house, behold, many tax collectors and sinners came, and were reclining with Jesus and his disciples. And when the Pharisees saw this, they said to his disciples, Why does your teacher eat with tax collectors and sinners? But when he heard it, he said, Those who are well have no need of a physician, but those who are sick. Go and learn what this means. I desire mercy and not sacrifice. For I came not to call the righteous, but sinners to repentance.
You go and do likewise.
Will rise up at the judgment of this generation and condemn it. For they repented at the preaching of Jonah, and behold, something greater than Jonah is here. There were some persons at that very time who told him about the Galileans whose blood followed him with their sacrifices, and he answered them, "Do you think that these Galileans were worse sinners than all the other Galileans because they suffered in this way? No, I tell you, unless you repent, you will all likewise perish. Or those 18 on whom the Tower of Siloam fell and killed him. Do you think that they were worse offenders than all the others who lived in Jerusalem? No, I can't. But unless you repent, you will all likewise." And sinners were all drawing near to hear him. And the Pharisees and the scribes grumbled, saying, "This man receives sinners and eats with them." So he told them this parable. What man of you, having 100 sheep, if he has lost one of them, does not leave the 99 in the open country and go after the one that is lost until he finds it? And when he has found it, he lays it on his shoulders, rejoicing. And when he comes home, he calls together his friends and his neighbors, saying to them, "Rejoice with me, for I have found my sheep that was lost." Just so, I tell you, there will be more joy in heaven over one sinner who repents than over 99 righteous persons who need no repentance. For what woman, having 10 silver coins, if she loses one coin, does not light a lamp and sweep the house of Saint diligently as if defying one? And she's found it, she calls to them her friends and neighbors, saying, "Rejoice with me, for I have found the coin that I have lost." Just so, I tell you, there is joy before the angels of God over one sinner who repents.
This is where the power of God is, out in the streets, people. It's not in a pew, warm in the pew, folks. It's not playing games, calling it youth church night. You know why I'm hard on you? Because God's going to be harder on you if you don't get your act together. You know, it's better for you just go home, quit calling yourself a Christian, and go for it, go off for your flesh and the devil, and quit being a hypocrite. Or, God for the gospel, get
we are suffering a terrible, terrible disgrace in this country of ours. And God is unmasking the hypocrites, and God is showing up the warmongers and the adulterers and the crazy dogs for who and what they are. And it is a shame that we have stopped standing for righteousness, that we stopped proclaiming holiness, and instead we make allegiance with the world and with the wiles of the devil. And we've been so passive in our Christianity that we've embraced every foul and every vile and unclean thing in the guise of peace. That is not the kind of peace that Jesus came to bring. The kind of peace that Jesus gives us is when we know that we're washed by the blood.
Besides a little short of breath. I feel real good. Yeah, that's what I thought.
We must fight and contend against sin and against the devil at all the ends. And if you think you can just go to sleep, that's exactly what you'll do. You'll go to sleep and you'll end up in hell. Amen?
So they went out and proclaimed that people should repent. You go and do likewise. In those days, John the Baptist came preaching in the wilderness of Judea. Repent, for the kingdom of heaven is at hand. You go and do likewise. From that time, Jesus began to preach, saying, repent, for the kingdom of heaven is at hand. You go. For the weapons of our warfare are not of the flesh, but have divine power to destroy strongholds. By truthful speech and the power of God, with the weapons of righteousness for the right hand and for the left, Peter said, "Lord, are you telling this parable for us or for all?" And the Lord said, "Who then is the faithful and wise manager whom his master will set over his household to give them their portion of food at the proper time? Blessed is that servant whom his master will find so doing when he comes. Truly I say to you, he will set him over all his possessions. But if that servant says to himself, 'My master is delayed in coming,' and begins to beat the male and female servants, and to eat and drink and get drunk, the master of that servant will come on a day when he does not expect him, and at an hour he does not know, and will cut him in pieces and put him with the unfaithful.
And that servant who knew his master's will but did not get ready or act according to his will receive a severe beating. But the one who did not know and did what deserved a beating will receive a light beating. Everyone to whom much was given, of him much will be required. And from him to whom they entrusted much, they will demand more.